say, it will be at the right moment, it will be very easy to get her out. All we have to do is free from custody somebody who's been legally convicted in a U.S. court and earned the name Merchant of Death. That's all we'll have to do. So you decide.
I want to touch briefly on the situation with Brittney Griner. For those who don't know, she is a WNBA star, plays for the Phoenix Mercury, and also a two-time Olympian. She was detained in Russia during the start of this invasion with possession of cannabis vape pens, as far as we know. Like, that's it, right? And she has been held in custody for months now. She's going to be facing trial for drug trafficking, apparently. This is very, very sad at one level that they're detaining this person for such a small, seemingly small thing. What is going on politically here? What is the U.S. trying to do to get her back? What is Russia's negotiating tactic? And I'm just going to add one more name to this thing, which is Victor Bout's name has come up. The Merchant of Death, famously portrayed by Nicolas Cage in an amazing movie. But let's talk about that. Is Russia looking to trade Brittney Griner for another high-value person, such as Victor Bout?
So can I say a couple of things by background first?
Mm-hmm. Yes,
first
please.
First of all, when I was a kid,
mm-hmm.
Americans could serve long jail sentences for possessions of small amounts of marijuana. And so Russia's harsh drug laws are, I think to us today, they seem bizarre and draconian, but it's just a matter of use. The other thing I'll say, two more things related to Brittney Griner. First of all, she's not just any basketball player. She's a fantastic basketball player. She's one of the best basketball players in the world. And this actually, Sar, this is not what you asked about, but just, you say, why is Brittney Griner playing basketball in Russia, even though she's one of the best players in the WNBA? And the answer is because players in the WNBA don't make very much money. And so many of them in the WNBA offseason go play in leagues overseas to basically try to make money. It's kind of the way that Major League Baseball players, would go play in Latin America or would sell insurance during the offseason back in the 30s and 40s and 50s.
Mm-hmm.
So despite the fact that she's one of the best players in the world, she doesn't certainly get paid like, basketball players in the NBA.
So she's essentially forced to go to Russia at some level to make money. She's forced to go to this country. Yeah.
Go somewhere. And Russia's got a big basketball league. There are some hockey players who have been playing in Russia as well. They left when the war started. She got nabbed. I think she was getting ready to leave and she got nabbed. And this was clearly something that the Russians had been preparing to do, right? They always have lots of options. So they grabbed her. I don't think we have any way of knowing whether she's actually guilty of anything, whether she actually possessed any marijuana products. We just don't know. I wouldn't rule it out because a lot of people use marijuana, but I also wouldn't take it for granted that they didn't just completely fabricate the charges. Right?
Mm-hmm.
We just don't know. And in the end, it's irrelevant. It's irrelevant because if she were as guilty as the day is long, the Russians could snap their fingers and let her go home for diplomatic reasons. And if she were completely innocent, they can put her in jail till the end of time if they choose to.
Mm-hmm.
The question, as you get to, is what are they up to? And by all accounts, they're probably trying to do two things. One is, again, to make a point, which is to remind the Americans, right, we can hurt you in all kinds of ways. And then the other is probably to trade her for somebody that we have.
Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned Victor Bout.
Mm-hmm.
This is classic Russian tactics, which is somebody will go to your country and commit a crime. And when you arrest them, we will then arrest somebody for no good reason and trade the innocent person back to you for the guilty person.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And another factor here I just want to bring up is Brittney Griner came out as a lesbian in 2013. Russia has been famously hostile towards the LGBTQ community, especially over the past few years. Putin has ramped up his rhetoric. There's been, violation of human rights, you could say. So does this have something to do with it as well?
I don't know. My guess is it's certainly the fact that she's black and that she's gay certainly will increase the everyday hostility that she is subject to in Russia. I suspect that those things were not coincidental in who they decided to arrest. Also her prominence, though. She's a name that's a much bigger name than a lot of other athletes. I also think, I mean, as bad as it would be in any situation to be in a Russian prison, to be black, gay, and foreign in a Russian prison, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Not speaking, I assume she doesn't speak much Russian, you know, the gang treatment, the treatment by the guards. It could be, if they don't do, you know, it could be horrible. We just mm-hmm. don't know.
Do you get the sense that the U.S. has this on their major priority list, that they're actively doing something about this situation?
Well, I think initially they were actively doing something by trying to fly beneath the radar, right? The initial strategy was to try to work behind the scenes, to try to not embarrass Russia, to try to basically say, is there a way we can work this out quietly? Now that it's been several months and that's not worked, there's this much more public discussion. And of course, the Russians are going public as well by announcing a date for her trial.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think there's any exact roadmap for this, but my general sense is they will try her, they will convict her, and then they will sentence her. And then once those things have happened, they will talk exchange.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be hard because if who they want is Victor Bout, I'm not sure the United States is going to do that.
Mm-hmm. Do you know if Victor Bout has significant ties to Putin's government? I mean, just to give a little bit of background, this is the man who is known as the biggest arms dealer in history. He was supplying arms to major conflicts worldwide, specifically African conflicts. Probably facilitated the death of who knows how many people.
Yeah.
Like I said, it was portrayed in this movie, Lord of War, probably a little bit of a fictional portrayal of this. But he is one of the most wanted men in the world. So I'm just curious. This does not seem like somebody the United States would readily give up to Russia. And I'm just curious, what does Russia want to do with Victor Bout?
Well, we don't know exactly, but I think there's the suspicion is that if he was a Russian and he was selling all these arms all over the world, he was connected with the Russian intelligence services. I mean, mm-hmm. probably with Russian arms, the mm-hmm. Russian arms industry. You know, and not only, of course, is Putin very connected with the intelligence services, but he's taking a cut off of all the sort of criminal activity, you know, emanating from Russia. Mm-hmm. So in a sense, going after Bout was going after somebody who I think probably was quote unquote under Putin's protection.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a very strong ethic, as there is in most intelligence services, right? There's a very strong ethic that if you're one of ours and you get caught, we will do whatever we can mm-hmm. to get you free.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That makes sense. So, like you said, we might have to wait until the sentencing and everything else before we figure out what happens to Brittney Griner.
You know, there's another American who's not quite as famous. His name is Paul Whelan.
Mm-hmm.
He's a former Marine. He was in Russia, I believe he had maybe a girlfriend in Russia, but he was just doing some stuff in Russia. Was there visiting, essentially, on a tourist visa. And some Russian friend of his handed him something. And whatever it was that this guy handed him had quote unquote confidential material in it. Whelan was arrested, right? So it was a setup from all we can tell. And Whelan's been in jail for much longer than Griner. It's been a couple of years now. And his family has been trying to get him free, but the United States has not been willing to do that, has not been able to, I should say, to get him free. And essentially, hard to imagine the Russians are going to let any of these people free without getting something back.
Can we at least be hopeful that the United States is utilizing as many resources as they see possible to help these people, though? I mean, the United States has sent in like SEAL teams and stuff to rescue people in different countries. They do negotiate. I mean,
isn't that a different Tom Cruise movie where he like has to drop into China somewhere? And
I'm sure it is. All of these movies have been made, but
Tom Cruise movies are not real. Let's just be clear about that, okay?
Top Gun, you're telling me Top Gun Maverick is not a real representation of what's going on right now?
Well, you know, I thought it was very interesting how the enemy in that movie was never mentioned, right? It's sort of these imaginary enemies, which is very politically correct, but...
Yeah. But in the also, world, in the first movie, it was never explicitly mentioned that it was Russian. But they had the MiGs, obviously, but it was never explicitly mentioned that these
countries fly MiGs. The Ukrainians fly MiGs. Yeah. Friends. So let's not dwell on that. But no, I mean, what are you going to do? You're going to drop some team halfway around the world in the middle of Russia and run an extraction out of a Russian prison and then fly them out again?
Yeah,
I think.
That might not be possible, but as far as like negotiation is concerned and like stuff like that, so we could be hopeful.
It's just a question. So let me try to flip the script, which is say it will be at the right moment. It will be very easy to get her out. All we have to do is free from custody somebody who's been legally convicted in a U.S. court and earned the name Merchant of Death. That's all we'll have to do. So you decide.
It's not an easy proposition. It's not as straightforward as
you know.
It seems.
There's an interesting story here, which is which we should talk about. Which is, you know, you remember you've seen this TV show, The Americans, right?
Oh yeah, which is an amazing show. I haven't seen the whole thing, but yes, I have seen that show.
Based on these Russian sleeper agents, which were living in the United States for a long time, eventually they were all arrested, or at least we hope they were all arrested. But a bunch of them were arrested. How did they get back to Russia? They were traded for basically a Russian who had spied for the United States and the Russians had captured a couple of people. One of those people was a guy called Sergei Skripal. Does that name ring a bell? Mm-mm. So we sent the Russian spies back to Russia. Mm-hmm. Russia freed the person who'd been spying for us, and he went to live in Salisbury in the United Kingdom. Mm. And then a couple of years later, the Russians showed up and spread Novichok on his doorknob and tried to kill him. Right, so the point is, even when you've made a spy swap, the Russians then go try to kill the person that they swapped. And they do it with nerve gas. Mm-hmm. Right? These are the people who ran the Olympics and set up the Olympics so that they could run a gigantic urine swapping operation so they could cheat systematically all across the Olympics. Mm-hmm. You know, there's this old saying, if you're not cheating, you're not trying. And, you know, I don't want to sound like I'm anti-Russian, but this is the way they play the game, right? If you're not cheating, you're not trying.
Mm-hmm. No, I think that's a great point. And we really do have to think about when we paint the United States as, you know, in any way, or rather Russia in any way is morally equivalent as what the United States is doing. You're getting into some dangerous territory here because it's
that
not
is
the
correct.
Same. At all. But
that is correct. And that's not in any way to whitewash any of the terrible things the United States has done over the years. And mm-hmm. it's a pretty significant list.
Yeah. And we've had that
it's
conversation.
It's not that we don't do terrible things. It's just that we do them differently and in different ways. And we should just recognize the ways in which Russia does terrible mm-hmm. things. And
yes.
we're delusional if we think that this is about law enforcement or criminal justice or anything like that. This is about getting bargaining chips with the United States. And then the question is, what can you get?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We'll see how it plays out then.
We will indeed.